Okay, Joel Plum Crazy Restorations, working on a 1968 Dodge Charger. It came in for mechanical and body and paint estimate. And let's start on the underside here. What do we have?
So far what I found is I took the wheels off. I like to take a look at the brakes. Brake shoe lining is good. It's good there. Wheel cylinders always look good. But let's take a look here. I like to peel them back a little bit. Let's take a look and see, you can see fluid here. See, when you see fluid on the inside here, it's actually come past the seal here, and that's not a good sign. So this wheel cylinder needs to be replaced.
Yeah, it's definitely
needed. And it's probably the same thing on this side. I just use a little bit of a screwdriver to give my finger a little bit of a chance to get a hold of it. And it's also wet. Yeah, you can see on the inside it's all wet there. So it's showing this wheel cylinder is actually leaking. Okay. So this wheel cylinder needs to be replaced. But other than that, this part is good. You can see where somebody has actually had these bolts out before to replace a lower ball joint. The lower ball joint has been replaced on this car, as well as the upper ball joint. And it's had quite a few pieces replaced on it. And along the other side here, it's got the same thing going on, except the wheel cylinder is good on this side with a new upper ball joint, a new lower ball joint, and it's got a new sway bar bushing link kit, so that's all good.
Okay, new shocks.
Yeah, new shocks. And what I did do is I tested the sway. Tested the pitman arm here. It's soaked in oil. That's not a big deal for the pitman arm, but pitman arm here. So I just give it a squeeze test to see if it had any movement, and it does. The pitman arm, when it's got movement like that, it's going to make it so it rocks back and forth, and so the pitman arm should be replaced.
Yeah, the customer did say that the steering felt quite loose for his.
For his liking,
yeah. So
this has got minimal amount. So this one's okay. All the rest are good, no problems with them. As you can see, it's got new carter pins in it.
Yes.
It's got new grease fittings. It's got a lot of new parts in this car.
That's good.
It's got new upper and control arm bushings. It's got a lot of new stuff in it. So this is a very good sign here. But it does have, what's not so good, is a lot of oil leaking on this car. And see, it's a lot of transmission fluid down here. Transmission fluid is red. So you can see the red transmission fluid. And it usually comes from an higher source. So you look up, and if you can see up, you see a dipstick itself is actually pushed out of the tube. When pushed out of the tube, it's usually a sign of too much pressure. And you can see actually it's underneath the radiator hose up there, and it's running along, so he's pushing up there, blowing back down, coming down here, making a big mess all over the exhaust, underside of the car, and just soaking everything. So it's showing either it's way overfilled, or else the breather is plugged and has to have some place to go. And
with
this much fluid, it looks like probably a combination of both.
Okay.
So I need to
we'll definitely have to check the fluid level on it and see where it's at.
See where that's all at there. Otherwise, underneath the car.
The transmission does look like it was a recent rebuild.
Yeah, so it's got gaskets here. It looks like someone's been in there not too long ago. So a breather may have got plugged up a little bit, but it's not coming from transmission lines. See, the fittings are all nice and dry up there.
Yeah.
And this fitting here is also dry, but what I've seen is just above it here, it's got a bit of transmission fluid coming from this adjusting nut here, and it's a little bit coming from here, so it's seeping past, so it's got a lot of pressure coming out of there.
Okay.
So I would have to take a closer look and see what's going on with that there.
All right.
And it's got a little bit of motor oil leaking from valve cover gases up there a little bit on the top of this one here, and the same thing with the other side. So it does have a little bit of oil issues, that's for sure. The transmission lines are wiggling around here a little bit. They really need to be tied back a little bit better.
So maybe some support bracket installed?
Yeah.
Okay.
It does have it going up into a transmission cooler, which is a good idea. I'd rather see a transmission cooler instead of going into the radiator. It's a much better idea to cool the transmission fluid.
Yes.
And coming back, you can see it's also wet all the way back.
Yeah,
it's blowing back.
Made quite a mess.
Yeah, the drive shaft here is being in good shape, no problems with that. The exhaust is all here, no issues with that. And it looks like someone has been into here before. It looks like it's been apart.
Mm-hmm.
So again, transmission fluid all the way back here.
Yeah.
And it's being adjusted back here. You can see on the one side here where it's being adjusted. Everything's looking nice and new. Mm-hmm. You can hear someone's done some good quality work. Okay. New shoes here still, so new enough where they look fairly new.
Okay.
No problems with wheel cylinders or anything there. But it does have some worn bushings on air shocks back here. It's like they've been there for quite a while. On this side, you can really see a lot of cracking on this side over here particularly.
Okay.
And...
yeah, the air shocks definitely look like they've been on there for a while.
Yeah, so they could be renewed or something different on there.
Yeah.
Whether the air shocks are there because the springs are weak, we'd have to let the air out of them and see if the springs are actually weak and need to be replaced or what's really happening.
There is a sign of tire rubbing on the inner or the quarter panel there, the wheel well. So
the tires might be a little bit too wide for this car.
Okay.
Let's see what's happening there. So it's kind of showing that also could be signs of the leaf springs may be a little bit too weak and so depending on the shock to do all the work.
Right.
So
newer gas tank on the car.
Yeah. So that's a good sign. Got some nice new tips on the back here. Looks nice.
Yeah, I don't like seeing radiator clamps for an exhaust hanger. So
no, that's a bad idea. That's for sure.
Yeah.
But it's nothing we can't fix, that's for sure.
Okay, well, overall the car is not bad at all. Just a few issues. Let's check this trans fluid level and see where we're at. And take a look at what we got on the top side.